This morning, I asked my parishioners, is anger a sin? Some of them said yes. Then I asked another question, was Jesus ever angry? And they said yes. Some said no. Then I asked the third question, did Jesus ever commit a sin? And everybody in the church said no. So I asked again, is anger a sin? This time around, they were all quiet. Dear friends, there is such a thing as holy anger. It is total rejection of something that is intrinsically evil. It was with holy anger that Jesus cleansed the temple in John chapter 2. Perhaps Jesus could have decided to persuade them with preaching, but Jesus knew that the best sermon in that situation was action. There are certain things that we cannot afford to be diplomatic about. In today's first reading, we see the story of Mattathias, the leader of the city of Modin. The king's officers came to that city trying to enforce the apostasy against the Jews. After the whole city was gathered together, they said to Mattathias, now you are a leader and you are well respected in this community. You'll be the first to come and offer sacrifices to idols. Initially, Mattathias thought he could be diplomatic about it. As soon as he finished speaking, a Jew came from the crowds and went on to offer sacrifice. When Mattathias saw that, he burned with zeal. Take note, that same word, zeal, is used with reference to Jesus in John chapter 2 concerning the cleansing of the temple. Mattathias went with zeal and holy anger and he killed the Jew upon the altar and also killed the king's officer. You know, the death of this Jew only reminds me of the saying of Jesus that anyone who tries to save his life will lose it. But anyone who loses his life for the sake of God will keep it to eternity. The Jew perhaps was afraid. He had been hearing of the deaths of the seven brothers, the death of Eleazar. He had been hearing of so many people who were killed because they refused to offer sacrifice to idols. And out of panic, he came forward to offer that sacrifice, not knowing that that would be the very last thing he would do in his life, knowing well that with this action of his, he had become an enemy of King Antiochus Epiphanes. Mattathias said to the crowd, let anyone who is with me come with me. And together they all went to the wilderness there to pray, to train, and to strategize to fight the enemy, the devil's incarnate, King Antiochus Epiphanes. Two lessons we learn from Mattathias. Number one, there is no way you can be diplomatic about sin. Secondly, you do not fight the devil with bare hands. You must take out time to prepare, to strategize, to pray, to fast, to recollect. Note that just as Mattathias went to the wilderness and gathered some followers with himself in order to fight, to prepare to fight King Antiochus Epiphanes, so also Jesus, at the beginning of his public ministry, went to the wilderness and 40 days and 40 nights he spent there praying and fasting to prepare himself. In our gospel passage today, we see that Jesus wept for Jerusalem. This cry of Jesus would materialize itself in the year AD 70, when Jerusalem will be leveled down and the temple will be brought down. Not one stone would remain upon another. Dear friends, we need to learn to weep for our sins because they deserve death. Above all, we need to pray for the grace of holy anger. To be angry enough with the devil so as not to engage him in negotiation. We need to be angry enough with our own sinfulness so as to completely and genuinely repent from sin.